Good YouTube, it's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, former unified WBC, WBA, welterweight, world champion, superstar boxer, Keith One-Time Thurman, he doubles down on the Errol Spence avoiding him talk. Errol Spence, undefeated unified WBC, IBF, welterweight, world champion, superstar boxer, who is considered by many to be top three pound-for-pound fighters in the world. Okay, so Keith Thurman, he doubles down on the PBC Premier Boxing Champions interview he just recently did, okay, regarding Errol Spence continuously avoiding him, according to Keith Thurman. So Keith Thurman is saying, you know, at this point in time, Errol Spence comments that Errol Spence is stating that he has no interest in facing off against Keith Thurman. He says that Keith Thurman, he pushed for a fight with Keith Thurman, and Keith Thurman just didn't want to give him an opportunity. Even after he beat Kell Brook, former IBF welterweight world champion, British superstar boxer in the UK back in 2017 for his first opportunity for a world title, he did so in dramatic fashion, stopping Kell Brook in the 10th round. And after that, he looked to unify against Keith Thurman, who was the WBA and the WBC welterweight world champion. After he defeated two-division world champion, superstar boxer Danny Swift Garcia, and two-time welterweight world champion, superstar boxer, Showtime Sean Porter. Well, Errol Spence, he saw it as an opportunity for a mega showdown, and he continued to pursue Keith Thurman. And Keith Thurman, well, he continued to turn down Errol Spence. And Keith Thurman, he cited that he saw Errol Spence as his super fight, but as his Manny Pacquiao, Floyd Mayweather fight. Keith Thurman, 29 wins, 1 loss, 22 wins by way of knockout. Keith Thurman stands at 5'7.5". With a 69-inch arm reach, okay? Keith Thurman is still a relatively young guy. You know, last time we saw him in the ring was July of 2019 when he lost to Manny Pac-Man Pacquiao. Keith Thurman has been having a lot of inactivity. Keith Thurman is 32 years of age, okay? So with that said, this is a fight that Errol Spence pursued quite a bit. You know, even on, as you can see on the picture right here, you know, when they came face to face on podcast, on networks, and you know, on pre-fight breakdowns, and you know, they did analysts together. You know, interviews at the same fights. Anytime they was in the same facility, Errol Spence, he pursued Keith Thurman. Okay, he let Keith Thurman know this is a fight that he wants. Errol Spence, 27 wins, no losses, 21 wins by way of knockout. He's 31 years of age. He stands at 5'9.5" with a 72-inch arm reach. Last time we saw him in the ring was December 5th of 2020 when he defeated that very same Danny Swift Garcia that Keith Thurman beat. And Keith Thurman makes mention of the dominant fashion that Errol Spence beat Danny Garcia. He says he dominated Errol Spence, but he didn't inflict a lot of punishment upon, he dominated Danny Garcia, but he didn't inflict a lot of punishment upon Danny Garcia. He just played it safe and just boxed him from the outside, sort of like he did against four-division world champion Mexican superstar boxer Mikey Garcia. So Keith Thurman, he doubled down. Last week, Keith Thurman, he stated that Errol Spence wasn't the truth, okay? He stated that Errol Spence wasn't the truth and that he had to prove to him that he was the truth. Now he doubles down on his PBC interview he does today. And he says that, you know, Errol Spence, you know, needs him to bring out the truth. Okay. If he's truly the truth, he would fight the best. He says, I'm a level above Danny Garcia and Sean Porter because I beat Danny Garcia and Sean Porter. This is another double down on what he said in his previous interview when he stated that, you know, Errol Spence is fighting his leftovers. So he's doubling down. He's saying that I'm a level above them, obviously, because I beat them. Right. And then he goes on to say, if you so badly wanted to fight me back then, why aren't you eager to fight me now? He says, if I wanted to fight you back then I still want to fight you right now. Well, now Keith Thurman is saying that. But back then, Keith Thurman was saying that Errol Spence had to do more. He had to let the fight marinate. OK, so essentially, Keith Thurman didn't want the fight. So why do you Keith Thurman want the fight now? Okay, so it's a contradiction to say the least. Okay, because Errol Spence was pursuing the fight. And now Errol Spence is saying, well, he don't want to fight Keith Thurman. Keith Thurman now lost to Manny Pacquiao. That's how Manny Pacquiao, 8-division world champion, legendary, iconic Filipino superstar boxer, who was the WBA champion because he just recently beat Keith Thurman, but he was stripped due to inactivity. The last time we saw Manny Pacquiao in the ring was the same time we saw Keith Thurman in the ring, okay? And so he says that he had a fight lined up after the Pacquiao fight to fight Errol Spence in the mega unification showdown, okay? So he's saying at that time, he all his plans was to fight Errol Spence. But back when Errol Spence was pursuing Keith Thurman wasn't a buy-in, and Keith Thurman didn't want to fight Errol Spence, and he continued to tell Errol Spence publicly, even when they came face-to-face, that you'll get your turn. Your time is coming. These are the words of Keith Thurman. Your time is coming. You're going to get your turn. Be patient. Okay? These are the words that Keith Thurman used when Errol Spence was in the same vicinity of him. They went in the same, Errol Spence is face-to-face with him, and this is what he was telling Errol Spence. So now Errol Spence has gotten to the point where he's saying, okay, now I don't want to, you know, pursue Keith Thurman. Okay, now you lost. Now you lost some of your luster. You're not a world champion. As Keith Thurman admitted, he said, I'm no longer a world champion, but my number one objective is still Errol Spence. Well, it's just hard for Errol Spence or the boxing fans in the boxing world to believe your number one objective is Errol Spence when you had the opportunity to secure a mega showdown with Errol Spence, and that wasn't your number one objective, okay? You had other plans, as Keith Thurman stated. He said that fight needed to build, okay? So Keith Thurman wasn't looking to give Errol Spence the opportunity. And now Keith Thurman is saying that if you're truly the truth, you would give the fans what they want. He's saying that now, if you truly wanted to fight me then you want to fight me now. So Keith Thurman is saying the chances if I wanted to fight you back then I want to fight you right now. This is what Keith Thurman is saying. So Keith Thurman is saying now, you know, you should still want to fight me as you wanted to fight me then. If you were motivated to fight me then, I don't know. He says that it's awkward to hear him say he's not interested in making the fight happen now. He says, it's very odd and strange that he don't want to fight me now, alluding to Errol Spence never wanted to fight him. Okay, that's what he's hinting at, that Errol Spence truly never wanted to face off against him. Okay, and so now he's saying now, well, you know, I'm my number one objective is Errol Spence. He says that, you know, he's the unified champion. You know, he's fought my leftovers. You know, he didn't dominate any guys. That's another contradiction, because he says he dominated Danny Garcia. He just didn't inflict a lot of punishment upon Danny Garcia. But then in the same token, he's saying it was a lackluster performance. He just did what he had to do to win the fight and survive. Okay. Well, Keith Thurman, when you saw Keith Thurman against Josito Lopez, you know, when he got hurt in the fight, he started utilizing the ring, started utilizing a lot of movement to avoid being in clashes with Josito Lopez, and the crowd started to boo. Okay, that was not the first time the crowd started to boo. You understand? Now Keith Thurman has a high ring IQ, very high boxing IQ. You know, he has great boxing ability, very good technical, very great technical boxer. Very athletic, and he has power in both hands, right? And he beat Sean Porter, right? So he stated that he uses his, you know, advantages in the ring, Errol Spence, and, you know, he sticks to him. Well, that's what you're supposed to do. You know, if you have an advantage in the ring, you're supposed to stick to the advantage. Why would you risk using anything else when one thing is working? If it's working, well, you continue to use it until, you know, they make an adjustment. And then you have to make another adjustment. If they don't make an adjustment, well, then why would you make an unnecessary adjustment? So Keith Thurman never truly showed any true, real interest in fighting Errol Spence. And at this point in time, and at this juncture in his career, Keith Thurman has lost a lot of luster, even though he only lost one fight to Manny Pacquiao, his most recent fight. It's just the inactivity. Okay, Keith Thurman, again, has been inactive. Keith Thurman out of the ring since July of 2019. That is not necessary, okay? Now, I don't know what's going on behind the scenes, you know, but Keith Thurman has had these hiatuses. And recently, Keith Thurman, he stated that he wasn't injured. You know, he's just been sitting on the shelf due to the global pandemic, okay? You look at the fight, since he fought Robert Guerrero, March of 2015, he fought Luis Collazo, July of 2015. Okay. Then he fought Sean Porter in June of 2016. And then he didn't fight again until March of 2017 when he fought Danny Garcia. So he fought once in 2016. Then he fought once in 2017. Then he didn't fight again until Josito Lopez 2 years later. Josito Lopez in 2019. Then he fought Manny Pacquiao in 2019. And then he hasn't fought again. 2 more years has passed by. Okay, so you say since 2016, Keith Thurman has fought 4 times in 5 years. I'm going to say it again. Keith Thurman has fought 4 times in 5 years. So his out of sight, out of mind. The sport of boxing, what have you done for Lee lately? Okay, that's why his stock has dropped. And then the last two times we saw him against Josito Lopez, he looked like he was on the verge of getting stopped. Now he weathered the storm, and he was able to, you know, get past Josito Lopez. But then you look at, you know, the Manny Pacquiao fight. He got dropped in the fight, hurt badly in the fight, looked like he would have been on the verge of getting stopped in that fight, and he lost a split decision. Now he had great moments in the fight against Manny Pacquiao, but he lost. And now, once again, he's inactive. So he went on a 2-year hiatus after the Danny Garcia fight. Then he came back for Josito Lopez, didn't look his best, fought Manny Pacquiao and lost. And now you're on another 2-year hiatus. So your stock has dropped, and now you want to go right back to the front of the line and pull Errol Spence. You know, when Errol Spence was trying to fight you since 2016, now 5 years later, your stock has dropped. You're no longer world champion, and now you want to pursue Errol Spence fight. So Errol Spence has no interest. I, as a fan of the sport of boxing, would love to see Errol Spence and Keith Thurman mix it up, because I believe that Keith Thurman is still a high-profile fighter. I still believe that Keith Thurman has a lot left in the tank, and I believe that Keith Thurman definitely could put up a major resistance with Errol Spence. But I'm still expecting Errol Spence to win the fight, but it would be a huge fight still. Now, we know Errol Spence, he's on the verge of fighting a Cuban star, WBA super champion, in welterweight super champion, Yordanis Ugas, in his next fight for a third belt. It's another unification bout for Errol Spence. He wants to capture the third belt that would put him one belt away from becoming undisputed. And the super fight is already set between himself and undefeated three-division world champion, who's the WBO welterweight world champion, is widely considered by many to be the number one pound-for-pound fighter in the world, in Terrence Bud Crawford. That's already a super fight. Yordanis Ugas, 26 wins, 4 losses, 12 wins by way of knockout. He's 34 years of age, stands at 5'9" with a 69-inch arm reach. Last time we saw him in the ring was September of 2020 when he beat Abel Ramos via split decision. He didn't look his best in that fight, but it's looking like July we could get Yordanis Ugas versus Errol Spence in a unification belt. So WBC, IBF belts for Errol Spence, WBA for Yordanis Ugas on the line. It's looking like July, the weekend of July 4th. For that fight. Now, Keith Thurman, he even threw his hat in the ring for that fight. He tried to navigate Yordanis Ugas to give him the fight, and he stated, if you beat me, then that makes the fight bigger between yourself and Errol Spence. So Keith Thurman is trying to place himself back in position, as understandable, to be able to, you know, become a world champion and get these big fights again. He says he's found his newfound hunger and love for the sport that he's never truly lost. He just, you know, had some injuries and some setbacks. So now he's looking to secure a fight with Errol Spence. So let's see how this unfolds. That's still a super fight, in my opinion. Still a, not a super fight. It's still a big fight, in my opinion. Errol Spence and Keith Thurman. I would still love to see it, but let's see how this unfolds. That's all I got for y'all, man. Make sure y'all hit the like button. Drop a comment in the comment section. Let me know what y'all think. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the bell icon to get all the new notification. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.
You know what it is, your boy Jaden Kiss. Make sure you check out Blue Blood Sports TV. It's going down.